kidneys, it can be a butcher's knife, it can be anything. And it can happen to anyone, anywhere, anytime. And so I could say that in front of that, the police is helpless. You could see that the French police is helpless on the attack on the Bataclan, for example. It took 4 hours for the police to intervene inside the theater. Can you imagine what was the situation of these people? They had cops around them. They had bloody killers, eviscerating people. And they had to wait 4 hours, 4 hours, to have some help. So the attacks are efficient in a way. They want to scare people, and people are scared all over Europe. The most theaters are almost empty. People know now that if they go to see a show, they risk to be killed. If they go to see fireworks, they know that they risk to be killed, etc. So it works, and it pushes people to surrender and to submit, and it works. But there is another tool that has been used, and it's obvious, but many people don't see it because it's so obvious. It's what Muslims call dawah. Dawah is invitation. They invite you to submit to Islam. So invitation could be seen as a nice word, but in fact it's not so nice. It's not so nice. Invitation is a kind of offer that you cannot refuse, mafia style. They have things in common with mafia. I could say that many Muslim movements in Europe work in the direction of dawah. They say it's not good to criticize Islam. If you criticize Islam, you take risk. And I could say that I can see the difference. 10 years ago, you could see many books criticizing Islam in bookstores in Europe. All these books have disappeared. It's almost impossible now to publish a book criticizing Islam. All the books you see are books that say Islam is wonderful, Islam is peace, Islam is love, etc., etc. You have to become Muslim. So it's really an invitation. It works. Islam says blasphemy is very bad. And in many European countries, blasphemy is almost forbidden. In the name of Islamophobia, you can be attacked and you can go to trial if you criticize Islam in a country like France, for example. It's becoming very dangerous to criticize Islam. I could have many, many other aspects. The situation of women. I could say that 10 years ago, you couldn't see a woman wearing a full black veil in France. Now, if I go in a supermarket in the suburbs of Paris, it's very hard sometimes to see women who don't wear a veil, if you go in some Muslim districts. So it's spread out very, very fast, and dawah works. And I could say that if dawah works, it's because political correctness works. And if political correctness works, it's because the left used political correctness as a tool. And I could say that the left has a huge responsibility in what's happening right now in Europe. The left has discovered that the left and Islam have something in common. They hate Western civilization. They want to destroy Western civilization. So they work together. Sometimes people don't understand. They say, oh, the left is feminist and Islam treats very badly women. But they have something more important in common, their hatred. The hatred is what brings them together. And it works perfectly in Europe. And I could say that if you look at the situation in Europe now, you can see that the media belong to the left largely, and not completely. You don't have Fox News in Europe. It's impossible to have Fox News, especially in France. France is completely lost. When I write articles, I go in the end on the French websites because I know that they lie. I want to see what's missing or how they lie. But first, I have to get the information to see that they lie. And I take the information here, for example. So the media are lost. The politicians are lost, mostly. If you look at the French politician, even in the so-called extreme right, they say, we shall build an Islam of France. I cannot understand how an Islam of France can be different from an Islam from Luxembourg or from Syria or from elsewhere. But they think that they can build an Islam of France that could be completely separated from the Islam of the rest of the world. And even the French Prime Minister said a few days ago, France will become an example for Islam. So I could say that French don't know really how to fight, but they know something, preemptive surrender. And I could say that they practice it very, very well. In some other European countries it could be different, but in France it's like that. So the situation is very hard because people in France are brainwashed. Even people who are angry about what's happening don't know what to do and don't know how to react, because they don't have the tools to react. They don't have the books to read to understand what's happening. So, as I said in the beginning, I think that it's necessary to understand all that in order to fight here and to understand that it's not too late for the United States and that many things have to be done. And I think that it's necessary to do it now without waiting, because if you wait for too long, it will be too late. It's almost too late now. And so I could say, you have to understand what did happen in Europe. What did happen in Europe is that you had a lot of migrants coming. So you have to stop infiltration of the United States by Muslims. And you have to know that the people who are coming from Syria, that some politicians in the US want to accept freely, you have to know that among these people, many people believe in Sharia and many people are fighters for radical Islam. You have to crush the source of all that. You have to crush the Islamic State and all the Islamic movement. You have to crush Islamic movements here. You have to see that organizations like CARE are totalitarian organizations. You have to see Islam as it is. You have to see that Islam is not a religion. It's something different. Islam is a totalitarian political movement under the government of a religion. And you have to see that, like all totalitarianism, Islam is fighting a war against the West, against freedom. And you have to see that we are in a war, and that in a war with totalitarians, you cannot have peace in any way. Either you win or you lose. And I'm here because I want to win. I don't want on the side of losers. And anyway, the side of losers is a side where you will not survive for very, very long. Because as I said in the beginning, these people love to die and love to kill. So we have a choice between strength and weakness, and I think that it's necessary to have a clear mind to understand what we are confronted with and to choose strength.